Once again, welcome to KINE 2350, Public Health Principles and Populations. In this module, we will look at basic public health concepts and terminology. You will learn how public health is related to healthcare and the difference in functions of each body. We will take a look at how public health approaches health in communities and touch on why public health topics can be so controversial. Your readings in this module include the first three chapters in the Schneider textbook, Introduction to Public Health, 5th edition. Students often ask me if the text is required in this class. I answer that for you with a loud and clear yes. Each week we'll conclude with a reading quiz that covers the module readings, videos, and assigned chapters. This is important, as not only does the quiz grade count toward your final grade, you will see similar material on both your midterm and final exams. So do get the textbook and do read the assignment chapters each week. Your learning trip in this module includes a lecture that I adopted from a Centers of Disease Control and Prevention resource. The lecture is engaging and provides you with a Public Health 101 type of introductory experience. The information contained in the lecture will contribute to your foundational knowledge in public health. I advise you to take your time and make good notes, as you will see questions on both the Module 1 quiz and the midterm related to this important information. Two additional short videos precede the featured video in this module. This featured video introduces you to Dr. Claire Pomeroy and the story of transformational life experiences that determined her public health pathway. In addition, she introduces you to the concept of social determinants of health, one which we will revisit often throughout the course. You may realize that you too have experienced transformational experiences which have influenced you to the point that you have placed a burden on your heart to serve the community and to help people. Or you may have developed a curiosity about disease, how it starts, how it spreads, and how it can be prevented, that has influenced you to think about public health. No matter which area of public health you are interested in, the video provides you with an overview of social determinants of health that you will remember. Be sure you take a few minutes to select a team health issue or topic and identify your partner or team members. I encourage you to review the signature assignment 1, Annotated Bibliography Assignment, located in the Module 1 folder, so that you are familiar with the assignment requirements prior to starting your research. Keep in mind that although this assignment is due in Module 2, I've provided you additional time to get started and do quality work, as this assignment serves as the foundational component of several of your assignments throughout the course. As you proceed through this and the following modules in this public health course, I encourage you to spend some time looking inward and allow yourself to think about how you are learning and growing as a person and as a professional during your Bachelor of Science in Public Health program. Are your perceptions changing or expanding as those relate to the right to health and quality of life for all people? What about the importance of prevention? Finally, where do you, as a future member of the public health workforce, fit in order to maximize your knowledge, skills, and abilities as a public health leader in your community? Not an easy question, I know. And finally, one of my favorite quotes to start you off. An individual has not started living until he can rise above the narrow confines of his individualistic concerns to the broader concerns of all humanity. Martin Luther King, Jr. Welcome to Public Health.